Prime Minister Anthony Albanese has addressed the Papua New Guinea Parliament, making an historic address. Chloe Boris joins us from Canberra. Chloe, he's the first Australian PM to visit in years.
Yes, he is, and Anthony Albanese is just wrapping up his speech to Papua New Guinea's parliament. He is the first foreign leader to ever do so, and he has said in there that Australia and PNG are not only partners but friends, mates and equals. That's the point he really stressed during his address, that our two nations, which are big players in the Pacific, are equals and need to work together to build a strong, secure and stable region that is, of course, against the back drop of some geopolitical tensions in the Pacific. There were some other topics he touched on in terms of working together around education and climate change. He did promise that Australia will increase the number of citizens from PNG who could come over on a working visa to work and travel in Australia. He said those opportunities will be expanded. And he does have another goal as well. He would like to see a Pacific Islander rugby league team in the NRL competing based out of PNG. We will give you some of that address now. It was a very warm and very friendly reception for Prime Minister Anthony Albanese.
Australia and Papua New Guinea are the closest of neighbours. We are the greatest of friends. For thousands of years.
From here, Prime Minister Anthony Albanese will have a bilateral one-on-one meeting with his PNG counterpart, PM James Marape. It is expected they will be discussing a security pact between the two nations. There's a little confusion as to whether it'll actually be signed today or just progress, but essentially that's all about enhancing cooperation between the two militaries. The federal government insists this isn't being driven by China's ambitions to up its defence presence in the Pacific, but says this will be a good thing for both Australia and PNG.
Thanks for that, Chloe Boris.
All of those details in 10 News First at 5 o'clock.
Yeah, Chloe's in Canberra.